just come in, I swear I'll leave. Won't take nothing but a memo from the house that built me.
I love stories, even as a child. I think it's my love of stories that kind of morphed into poetry, then morphed into lyrics, and then morphed into songs. I kind of grew up in a creative household, and we had stories and songs and music that just kind of led me to this moment tonight. I'm Tom Douglas, and this is my Opry debut. Well, that is pretty wild, isn't it? Man. Well, grew up in Atlanta, and I came to Nashville the first time at age 27. Nashville, you know, it's a wonderful town, but it's a heartbreak town at the same time. And the heartbreak can get so heavy at times that you just have to escape. And I lost my confidence, and my father got ill at the same time. So I just said, I gotta start over. I gotta do something. I need to reinvent myself. And got married and reinvented myself as a real estate broker. And through that time in Dallas as a real estate broker, I found myself again and found the gift of creativity. I was gone 13 years before I moved back. But you know, it took years of just trying to quit trying to write a song that was commercial and just trying to write one true sentence that might lead to a song. And you know, over the next couple of years, I just kind of slowly started writing again. And lo and behold, once I was kind of, I found that freedom, I wrote a song and people liked it. Finally got my first country song recorded at the age of 41.
The thing that's special about the art of songwriting is it's the craft of combining real human emotion with melody and lyrics. Tom is a world-class master of this. Tom and I both met before we moved to Nashville. I was just a young dreamer. Tom was a hobby songwriter and he was selling real estate. And I had read an article about Tom in the Dallas Morning News. And I looked him up in the white pages and asked him, could I come to his house and just talk to him about songwriting? And now here, 25 years later, I'm the CEO of the publishing company that gets to work with him.
I don't think I've ever had a song recorded where I wasn't just thrilled. Just to see somebody interpret what you do, like I'm giving you the original, and then what's fun to see is when they take that original and then it kind of reveals itself in this whole different fashion. It's magical. In 2014, I was inducted into the Nashville Songwriters Hall of Fame. And I gave a 12-minute induction
speech. Thank you very much.
And in 2018, I was particularly frustrated and discouraged with what was going on. You know, I feel like I write all these songs and they go into a black hole, nobody cares, my life has no meaning. But I got to see Bruce Springsteen on Broadway. He had a one-man performance called Springsteen on Broadway. It was Springsteen's story and songs. He was talking about growing up in Freehold, New Jersey, and it took me back to 3018 Oregon Drive. And I thought, that's it, that's what we do. We just tell our story, and if we tell it effectively, it's gonna take you back to your childhood. So kind of once I had that template, my son and I took my acceptance speech and we blew it up to about 56 minutes, a one-man performance. I did that over 100 times. An Oscar-nominated director from Ireland was here. He saw it. He said, I know how to make that into a movie. I made a movie called Love, Tom, which is a letter of hope to a desperate world. And through that, I want the audience to find themselves and remember who they are, where they're from, and to whom they belong.
It's such an honor for me to play my song, The House That Built Me, at the Grand Ole Opry. The Grand Ole Opry is the house that built country music.
The song really is like a guide. We're just trying to guide the audience, the listener, into their own story. That's why I do it.
I won't take nothing but a memory from the house that built me.
Thank you all.